and you want the grid, you want to inform the grid of what you want to see in their programming for the next year. So you you have that on your agenda, and you reach out to all the schools in the area, high schools, junior highs, elementary, and you bring them all in. That's targeted outreach, right? Your messaging. So, you know, it's clear, concise, consistent, but the most important that I always tell people, it has to be compelling. So you go to someone and say, hey, huge shade tree, you're going to give us this year after year, priority with the space shuttle, and it just goes on and on and on. This is the agreement that they were able to band together and get. One of the Work Effort Commissioners gives out awards every year, and they were one of the awardees for their efforts. But this is what they did as they put council when they stood together and said, no, this is, we're not going to accept a tree for a tree. This is what we want. And so these are the things that you can do when you advocate. You have the mayor's budget day. The mayor shows up to the budget day. So did the controller show up to the budget day. What are the priorities for your area? What are the priorities for the East Side? Who's communicating them? Are they communicating the needs for your neighborhood council area? You just check in on that. We have budget advocates, and there's you should have a budget rep on your council, as well as a budget, two budget advocates per this, two or three per this region. So you need to know who those are, because they're voicing your opinion, their opinion about what the needs of this area are to the mayor, to city council, okay? Advocating city council members, you have your elected officials here, so you can, that's a direct fill-in. But there's a couple of tools. Anybody here sign up for the council file management system? Awesome. And do you sign up for committee referral?
No.
Okay. Let me back up. Council file management system, you can go to the city of LA, it's on the city clerk's website, and you need to sign up for that. If you want to know what's going on in the city, that's the place to get the information. You have committee referral, and then you have all the committees that the city council staff, our department, every department reports to a committee. Our department reports to education and neighborhoods. So if you want to know what's going on in education and neighborhood, in the neighborhood council world, then you need to check out education and neighborhood. Parks is the chair of that committee. But beyond that, committee referral, the reason why I say sign up for committee referral, because before it gets to council, in most cases, it goes on the committee referral. Now, of course, they can bypass that and go straight to council. However, if you want to keep your pulse on it, all the council files before they get to council are on that committee referral sheet, and they send it out, and all you have to do is subscribe to it, and you don't have to do anything else but subscribe, and it sends it out anytime that they post one. So it's important for you to see what's going through, because say there's something that's coming to your neighborhood, council that you want to be aware of, but if you're not checking the council agenda or that committee referral, you're going to miss it. So I would say for all the committee chairs, or for those who are going to be committee chairs, you should sign up for the committee that reflects the committee that you're going to be creating within your neighborhood council. Along with that, community impact statements. Neighborhood councils are the only body that is able to do a community impact statement. And a community impact statement is, say, council file. So anything that goes on the agenda for the city council will have a council file. So say there's something on the agenda that this neighborhood council wants to oppose, then you can submit to the through the city clerk an official statement of the board, so the board would have to agendize it, vote on it, write it up, approve it, and submit it. 100 words. If you could do more than 100 words, but you'll have to send that manually to the city clerk on the system, you can submit 100 words. There's five people that are, you can vote to have up to five people that have access to submit them, but of course it has to be official record. But it's reflected in council agenda or council committee. Oh, LA 32 submitted a community impact statement. It's there. So the city council are looking at that. Oh, okay. And that's one of the ways that the city council is also monitoring if their councils are really providing the advice that they were mandated to do via the charter. So remember, we said increased participation. more you do, the more you practice it, the more you'll get it. So with that, I thank you for your time, and I'll turn it over to my colleague. I'll ask if you have any questions. I'll be more than happy to answer them, but I am sensing that people want to move on. Okay, so I'll turn it over to my colleague.
I'm sure that has something to do. Thank you. Chair, next Thursday up here.
Tuesday?
Is that this Thursday or next Thursday for up to all the stuff? No, that's over there in Flatbow Park. But you're having one up here, I think. Is it tomorrow?
Tomorrow. Thank you.
you have a chart loading, but you go, it starts with a department, you set up your neighbor, you set up your checking account. Once you select your treasurer and your second finder, those two will need to come to the department and sign the bank documents, okay? And then once your checking account is set up, then you are able to receive funding requests from nonprofits and public schools, so they have the agendas. Once the board approves the funding request, then they will authorize the cardholder or treasurer or the second finder to move forward to receive all the paperwork from the vendor for the organization. Then it goes to the treasurer, makes the reports, and then has to come back to the board for final approval, and then goes to the department for the final approval. So there will be dual responsibility, the treasurer and the second signer. So there's no alternate signer, there's only one second signer. Okay? So the board will select the treasurer and the second signer. Between those two, you will decide who's going to be responsible for preparing the board for the report. The report means the monthly reports of all your expenditures. This is the expenditure to be targeted by the 10th day following your next board meeting. And then the other person will put out the check on board. So you will decide who's going to do that. And once you decide, you need to let the department know who's going to be responsible for which part. Okay, so the reporting responsibilities are in forms. There are numerous forms. Once the treasurer comes to the, and the secretary comes to the other training, we will provide all the forms for you. There's the monthly cash request form, there's the funding request form, the monthly expenditure report, the supplemental cash request form. The supplemental cash request form is if you need additional funds in your complete this morning is limited to the department. You will be given a sequence of $4,000 on your checking account. If you need additional funds, we can provide proof and why you need additional funds. You will also receive a debit card. And your debit card amount is per day is $200. This debit card is only to be used for incidentals, for last minute things such as, oh, I forgot to buy refreshments for unneeded, so you can use that for that. And time sensitive payments. Yes.
I understand that you can no longer use the card to pay cash.
There's
right?
No pay cash. You cannot use the debit card to withdraw cash. No cash out. And this person needs to present all forms and reports to the board for approval, to the agenda,